thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first and great commandment. The second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Merciful Lord, we beseech you to cast thy bright beams of light upon thy church, that it, being illumined by the doctrine of thy blessed apostle and evangelist, St. John, may so walk in the light of thy truth, that it may at length attain to life everlasting. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, who has given us thine only begotten Son, to take our nature upon him, and is at this time to be born of a pure virgin, grant that we, being regenerate and made thy children by adoption and grace, may daily be renewed by thy Holy Spirit. Through the same our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the same Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Please be seated and listen attentively to the words of Holy Scripture.
The Old Testament reading from the book of Exodus in the 33rd chapter, beginning at the 12th verse. And Moses said unto the Lord, See, thou sayest unto me, Bring up these people, and thou hast not let me know whom thou wilt send with me. Yet thou hast said, I know thee by name, and thou hast also found grace in my sight. Now therefore I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. And he said, My presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. And he said unto him, If thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence. For wherein shall it be known that here that I and my people have found grace in thy sight? Is it not that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated, and I and thy people, from all the people that are upon the face of the earth. And the earth said unto Moses, I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory. And he said, I will make thee all my goodness pass before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will show mercy upon whom I will show mercy. And he said, Thou canst not see my face, for there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, Behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And it shall come to pass, that while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cliff of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I press by. And I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise. Psalm 24 on page 368 of the Book of Common Prayer. Page 368, Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord's, and all that therein is.
Compass of the world, and they that dwell therein.
For he hath founded it upon the seas.
Established it upon the floods.
Who shall ascend unto the hill of the Lord?
Who shall rise up in his holy place?
Even he that hath clean hands and a pure heart.
And hath not lifted up his mind unto vanity, nor sworn to deceive his neighbor.
He shall receive the blessing from the Lord.
And righteousness from his God and his salvation.
This is the generation of them that seek him.
Even of them that seek thy face, O God of Jacob.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors.
And the King of glory shall come in.
Who is this King of glory?
It is the Lord strong and mighty,
even the Lord mighty in battle.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and ye be lift up, ye everlasting doors.
And the King of glory shall come in.
Who is this King of glory?
Even the Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory.
Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, and now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Please be seated. The epistle was written in the blessed apostle John's first letter, in the first chapter, beginning at the first verse. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hands have handled, of the word of life. For the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you, that ye also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father, and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. This then is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him, and walk in darkness, we lie, and do not the truth. But if we walk in the night light, and he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not with us. For if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins, and to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks
be to God. Please rise
to the
gospel.
The gospel hymn is hymn number 524. Sing two verses, please. Follow thou me. Then went the saying abroad among the brethren that the disciples should not die. Yet Jesus said not unto him, he shall not die. But if I will that he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? This is the disciple which testifieth of these things and wrote these things, and we know that his testimony is true. And there are many also other things which Jesus did, which if they should be written every one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that should be written. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Simple, beautiful, and it will give you a real appreciation for what it is to be an Anglican and what the
prayer life of an Anglican layperson is really all about. So I think that you'll be blessed by it. We'll make sure that everybody has at least one copy for each of their households so that you can have it as we go into the end of the new year, whether or not you join us for the classes or not. Alan?
Are we going to have Bible study sometime?
Good point. Yes, we are. Father Tim actually has two Bible studies. He's not feeling well, unfortunately, so I think that's been part of the reason that we've done it. He was going to do St. Matthew, and you can see he's not here today. He's got a problem with his esophagus now. So we'll keep him in your prayers. We've been lax on doing that, and I apologize. We will get it going so that we have it. If he can't do it, then I'll do it. And we'll get rolling here in January as well. We need to figure out a good day for it, that work. Now, we also have ladies' lunch coming up this month, right? Do you want to talk about that and invite the ladies?
January 9th, Cafe Margo.
Cafe Margo.
We're going to meet in the parking lot.
Okay.
If anybody wants to talk, we'll let them know where it is or just to follow. It'll be 11 o'clock.
Okay. Sounds good.
That's Copa Village.
Anything else that I'm... All right, great. We'll get started with the sermon. Go ahead. The sermon hymn is 355. Miracle that he had done for them before. And so they all recognize, but especially Peter recognizes, that this is Jesus. And so he just jumps into the water and swims to shore, leaving his buddies behind, struggling with the nets, trying to get all the fish in the boat while he gets to shore, because he's really glad, he's joyous to see Jesus, his friend, you know, his mentor, his Lord. And Jesus, when the other guys get to shore, sets up a little breakfast. He cooks some fish for them, and he gives them both the fish and bread, communion, and begins to talk to them, give them his farewell messages to them. And in the course of doing that, he looks at Peter and says, "Lovest thou these," meaning the fish, "more than me?" And Peter answers and says, "Lord, you know that I love you." Yeah, you know that. And Jesus looks at him again and says, "Lovest thou these more than me?" Now Peter's beginning to squirm a little bit because it's been repeated, right? And he says, "You know that I love you. No, you more than anybody know that I love you." And Jesus looks at him and says one more time, "Lovest thou these more than me?" And Peter, realizing that because he had betrayed Jesus three times, was going to have to apologize three times, to commit himself to Jesus three times. And he does what all of us would do in that same situation. If Jesus was standing in front of us and calling us out for our failings, he looks over at John and says, "What about that guy? Why are you picking on me? What about him? What's he going to do?" Because that's the way it is, isn't it? That's the way mankind reacts. You've probably heard the same thing from kids around the Christmas tree over the last couple of days. "What about them? Why do I always have to do the dishes?" Right? That's our nature. It goes back. They learn that from us. We learn it from our parents. It goes all the way back to Adam and Eve, when God met with Adam and Eve in the garden after they had tasted of the fruit. And he says, "What did you do? Told you you were naked." Adam went, "What about her? She made me do it." And when he confronted Eve, she said, whoa, "What about the devil? The devil made me do it." That's been our habit, isn't it? When it's time to confront our own sins, we begin to shift blame. We begin to point fingers and to ask that the attention be put someplace else, so we can understand how exasperated Jesus was, lovingly exasperated, when he looked at St. Peter and said, "What is it to you if that man lives until I come back in my glory? You feed my sheep. Do your job." Don't shift blame, don't point fingers, accept your responsibility and change your life. And that's really the point of this particular passage in the Gospel. St. John had two reasons for writing it. One is that the people were beginning to believe that he was going to live forever, thinking that Jesus had said that in this encounter. And as St. John writes, he said he didn't say I would live forever. He said, "What is it to you if I lived forever? Do your job," to St. Peter. But the other reason he wrote this passage is because with the resurrection, and with, as the epistle tells us, the gift that we become the children of God, the old ways of living, the ways of Adam, the way of mankind before Pentecost, is not going to be adequate anymore. That we will have a different standard, that we will have to live up to being Christians. We will have to be better than the Jews, and that they stopped reflecting the love of God to the world. And we have inherited that responsibility to be the hands of Christ, the voice of Christ that talks in comfort, to be his presence in the world. And that's a big responsibility. responsibility. Now we're coming, of course, up to the Feast of the Circumcision, or as we know it more readily in the secular world, New Year's Day, right? And on New Year's Day, I mean, the reason that we have the Feast of Circumcision is that Jesus gets his new name. He gets his official name. He becomes named in God. It's the Jewish equivalent of his baptism. And so we celebrate that. But in the secular world, we celebrate these amendments of life that we make on New Year's Eve, right? Resolutions, New Year's resolutions. So I'm going to suggest that we as Christians make some New Year's resolutions as we go into this new year and leave this very strong year. And for our resolutions, I'm going to ask us to look back at Scripture and to see the behavior of the great saints and what it is that we should be emulating as 2021 begins to come into our lives. The apostles who were gathered with St. Peter and St. John after Pentecost practiced their faith robustly and publicly, even in hostile environments. They were persecuted for it. All but John were martyred for it. But they did it cheerfully and in good faith and with tremendous courage. How can we emulate that in the world to come? Maybe we can say grace when we're having dinner publicly or having dinner at our house before a meal. That says something really powerful to the world. When you make that sign of the cross and say grace before a meal, what you're saying is, I'm willing to be judged as the emissary of Jesus. I make it known to you that I am a Christian. And all the people around will be watching, judging, trying to see if you can live up to what it was that you just proclaimed. That's a really important thing that we can do going into the new year. And another place in the scripture was a young girl who faced an unwanted pregnancy, and her husband faced ridicule and scorn and disgrace from his friends and his family because his girlfriend was already pregnant. But they didn't run away from the harsh start to their life. They told the angels that attended them, be it unto me according to thy will. And so they accepted the difficulties that came with their life. They embraced them. They looked for the grace and the blessing that would come from it. And so as 2021 comes in, let's embrace the difficulties and the unexpected embarrassments that we have in our life, the way that Mary and Joseph. St. John, the beloved apostle, the one who was not martyred, who stood at the foot of the cross with Jesus as he died and with Mary, his mother, accepted Mary as his own mother, adopted mother, to care for when Jesus said, Son, behold your mother. In the coming year, we can strive to love and care for our own families the way St. John cared for his adopted mother. That same beloved apostle John, as I said, did not really live forever, but he did live to be very, very old, and he didn't live the kind of romantic old age that is popular in movies and fictions. He was brittle, and he was stiff, and he was in pain. And he was suffering the same thing that all of us that get to that age suffer, which is the loss of people who are very dear to us. And he mourned for them, and he ached for them. And he was so fragile that when he couldn't do anything else and couldn't even get to the church, they would bring babies to his bedside so that he could baptize them from the bed. Maybe for 2021, we can remember that the aches and pains that we have, our health, good and bad, is a gift from God, and that we can offer up those difficulties and sufferings and pains that we have, both physical and emotional, as a gift and a sacrifice to God and as an example to the world. St. Stephen, whose feast was yesterday, followed the example of the Lord when he forgave his persecutors as they were killing him, begging God not to lay the sin of murder to their charge. let go of grudges. And yes, people betray us. People hurt us. That hurt is real. Hurts worse than physical pain. And yet, Jesus requires of us that we emulate him and that we forgive those who hurt us the way we would hope to be forgiven by him. Let's make forgiveness part of our resolutions for 2021. And I want to close talking about a group of guys, right? Just a group of guys out doing their job. They were young guys, generally the youngest in their family, or people who were least favored sons, or they were the less favored of the hired hands. They worked a dangerous job. They were outside in bad weather. They worked third shift, worst hours available. But you know what? Despite all that, they went and they did their job. And we know that they did their job because St. Luke records that when the baby Jesus was born, he went to those shepherds who lived a really rough, hard life. And they were the first ones that were called to proclaim the new king and to sing with the angels. Just a bunch of guys doing their job, going to work, doing the best they can. That's something to emulate. That's something for us to admire. That's something for us to try and become. Now, resolutions don't all have to be nowadays, right? For all those people, for the sacrifices they made, they received grace. They received blessing. They received the peace that passes all understanding. And they received courage to face death, even terrible death, with the sure knowledge that they were going to be united with their Lord and Savior and with their Father and to be with their loved ones in heaven. And they had no doubt about that. They were sure. And that is a tremendous gift. And it's the gift that holds us until we come to that ecstatic joy that is reserved for us that we can barely even imagine with our lives in this world. So there is, in the year to come, along with these opportunities for us to lift up our lives and to be more Christian, there is also going to be blessings, and we should embrace them. So, let's emulate those poor shepherds. Let's get out and do our job in the cold, in the night, in the day, whenever we're called. And as we do those jobs, as we emulate and become Christ's hands and voice and heart in the world, we should keep our ears open because you never know. We too might be called to sing with angels, to proclaim peace on earth, goodwill towards men. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven.
We got news this morning that Patricia West, who was a longtime member of this parish, a founding member of this parish, passed away back in August of COVID after a terrible fall. So as we finish celebrating this Mass, we'll be dedicating it to Patricia West. And we will have a memorial service for her at a time in the future, and I'll let you all know when that is. But she was a great loss to this parish, and we will miss her. O Lord, help thine own have we given thee. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our hands for the praise and glory of his name for our benefit and that of all of his holy church.
Almighty and ever-living God, by thy holy apostle, has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church, the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also, so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and to other ministers, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Gina, Paula, Danielle, Connie, Simone, Joanne, Stephanie, Denise, Marilyn, Edwin, Lynn, Norma, Will, Pat, Melody, Eileen, Michael, Richard, Lauren, Lee, Nikki, Lam, Lee, Father Tim, Sean, Jim, Joe, Barbara, Susie, Chris, Yvonne, Jack, Carrie, Catherine, Megan, Leona, Marion, Matthew, Thang, Moon, the Wood family, Donna, John, Rita, Grace, Jason, Danny, John, Michael Sr., Tyler John, Bishop John, Jamie, and Cook, and Jeanette. And for those in travel, Sue, Gina, and Danny. For those in the military, Corey, Crystal, Josh, Dean, Lance, Forrest, Haley, Karen, Sage, Taylor, Christine, Chris, Austin, Justin, James, Johnny, Catherine, Kyle, Kendall, and Andrew. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy service departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of the heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. You do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and our love and charity with your neighbor, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make an humble confession unto Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge as you bring our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most fiercely have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life. The honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins unto all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn unto him. Come unto me, all ye who travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You're also at St. Paul's. So, this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. You're also at St. John's. If any man sin, you have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up my heart, Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, because thou didst give Jesus Christ, thy only Son, to be born at this time for us, who by the operation of the Holy Ghost was made very man, the substance of the Virgin Mary, his mother, and without spot of sin to make us clean from all sin. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy give thy only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And in institute, and in his holy gospel, command us to continue, perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, to celebrate and appear before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. We most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we often present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and make one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, be all honor and glory, world, Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
And now as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our righteousness, but in thy death for the greater justice. We are not worthy so much as to gather our crumb unto thy table. Thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore grace, Lord, so that we eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and drink his blood, that our sinful body may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may come to the Lord God with him, and heal us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof.
But to speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof.
But to speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof.
But to speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Savior Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs to the hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works that thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and with thee and the Holy Ghost, be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. We stand for me in saying the Gloria in Excelsis. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only art Christ, with the Holy Ghost, our most high, and glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Peace of God, which passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forward in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The recessional hymn is 158.